Okay, dear children, now we have to continue the next topic, that is the abolition of slavery. So far I have discussed with you the certain important concepts regarding the French Revolution. We had come across the Reign of Terror in the period in between 1793 to 1794. Why it is known as Reign of Terror? And again, we had discussed the points regarding Robespierre's welfare policies. Again, we have, after that, we have discussed the next government, that is the after the fall of Jacobin Club, what type of government it was formed in France. Then we had discussed about the woman, position of woman in French Revolution, before French Revolution and during the revolutionary period. So far, these all topics we had covered. Next, we have to study about the abolition of slavery. As you know that slavery was very important concept or feature of European society those days. Slavery was very important, or slaves were very important for business people for loading and unloading and various other activities. So there was slavery, or slave trade was going on in Europe. Europeans had to go and work in distant places. That is why they had to, as there was a shortage of labor in the plantation, so they had to hire labor, or means they had to hire, or they had to buy the slaves for this work. So there was a triangular slave trade in between Europe, Africa and America. As you know that Jacobin Club had abolished slavery in France. So Jacobin Club under Robespierre, which abolished slavery in France. And there was triangular slave trade between Europe, America and Africa. But we could see that there were two important ports which prospered for this slave trade in France. The important port cities were known as Bordeaux and Nantes. Bordeaux and Nantes, these two cities, these two port cities were flourished for slave trade. And there were huge demand for slaves. So, for various colonies in Caribbean, they had to supply the commodities such as tobacco, indigo, sugar, coffee, etc. There was need of slaves. But there was a huge criticism in the 18th century regarding the slavery in France. So 18th century, there was criticism of slavery in France. And in the government which was formed after the Jacobin Club in 1794, that was known as the Convention, that means two elected legislative and legislative councils and a directory, as we have discussed before. That convention, that government which legislated to free all the slaves in the French overseas possessions. So it was our convention in 1794 which made a law to free the slaves, that was one of the important point regarding the convention or the government which formed in 1794. But we could see after 10 years when Napoleon came into power, he had reintroduced slavery. So once Jacobin Club abolished slavery, and when Napoleon came into power, he had reintroduced slavery. And finally, slavery was abolished in French colonies in 1848. Every French colonies from these French colonies, finally, slavery was abolished in 1848. Next thing we have to study about, that is the revolution and everyday life and the conclusion. The revolution, which was the very important, remarkable revolution in the European history, that was French Revolution of 1789. As we had discussed before, in Bastille, the storming of Bastille in 1789, After that, the years followed. France saw many changes in the lives of women, men and children. So many revolutionary governments came and they passed the laws which would translate the ideals of liberty and equality to the people and in the practicing in everyday life. So one of the important law, one of the important law which came into effect during storming of Bastille prison in 1789 was the abolition of censorship. Censorship was prevailing in France. Louis XVI had followed censorship which was prevailing in France, and in 1789 during the French Revolution by storming the Bastille prison, after that abolition of censorship which came into effect. Soon after the abolition of censorship, we could see that newspapers, booklets, printed pictures, magazines, etc. flooded in the towns of France. Various places of France, we could see various types of newspapers, pamphlets, books, printed pictures, etc. and which traveled rapidly into the countryside. These all which came to be used by the people in the village side even. And this was one of the important change which happened after the French Revolution in 1789. Freedom of press also meant for meant those opposing views of events could also can be expressed. Freedom of press was available, means abolition of censorship in the sense freedom of press. Even freedom of press included those who want to criticize, they have the liberty to criticize and publish it. Such way we could see the changes in entire France. Many plays, songs, festive processions, etc., which attracted large numbers of people in France, and many philosophers' ideas even circulated among the educated people in France. The ideas of liberty, democratic rights, which were the common and very important features of French Revolution, became the legacy of French Revolution. These ideas of liberty and democratic rights even spread from France to rest of the Europe during the 19th century. So this type came to be known as the legacy of French Revolution. The legacy of French Revolution includes the democratic rights, liberty, etc., ideas of liberty, etc., spread to from France to other European countries, and even our Indian leaders such as Tipu Sultan, Rajaram Mohan Roy, were the people or individuals who responded to the ideas from the revolutionary France. These two peoples were also inspired by this French revolutionary ideas. This came to be known as the legacy of French Revolution, means the ideas of liberty, democratic rights everywhere, in not only in Europe, various parts of the world it was spread. So these are the important topics that we have discussed today in the lesson French Revolution.